This video is on patient safety and medication administration. When we consider patient safety, we always have to look at the 8 rights of medication administration. That's the right patient, the right drug, the right dose, the right time, the right route, the right documentation, the right diagnosis, and the right response. You'll notice with different textbooks, they may have 7 rights or 6 rights. This is constantly changing, and it's according to what reference you look at, but we're going to go by our textbook. So we have the 8 rights of administration. So the first right is the right patient, of course. We want to always ask our patient their name and their date of birth. It takes 2 identifiers to identify the correct patient. We want to compare the medication record with the patient's ID bands. So that's another safety thing to ensure that you have the right patient. Remember that the room number is never an identifier for the correct patient. Next is the right drug. The first thing that you want to think about with the right drug is that you do 3 checks on that drug. The style, the way that that can happen may vary with nurse or the one that's administering the medications or the facilities that you work. That may play out different. What I do in the hospital is as the drawer opens with the electronic dipole, I do my first check of medication. I close the drawer and I do my second check. Then in the room, when I bar scan the medication and after, of course, I've identified my patient, then that's when my third check of medication happens. But somehow make sure that that happens. Get your eyes on that medication 3 times before you administer it to the patient. Be aware of your look-alike, sound-alike medications. All your facilities will have those listed posted, so be familiar with those. A good example of that is Oxycontin and oxybutyrin. Oxycontin, of course, is a Schedule II narcotic. It's a very powerful pain medication. Oxybutyrin is for urinary incontinence, so those are very different medications. Again, you have your black box medication and the high alert medication. Know what your facility policies are with your high alert medication. Know that they have an increased potential to do harm. So take extreme caution with those medicines. Many facilities will have you get 2 nurses' signatures, and 2 nurses must look at those medications before they're administered. Examples of those would be heparin and insulin. Lastly, give medication only if you have prepared it. Don't ever give a medication if someone else has prepared that. Next is the right dose. If that dose seems inappropriate for some reason, make sure that you call your provider and you double check that. And of course, with dosage, make sure that your drug calculations are correct. I think an important safety thing is if you're doing a drug calculation, have another individual, another nurse, check that calculation with you to make sure that it's correct. For the right dose, also be aware of your population. You know, our geriatric patients, they have decreased absorption. Their distribution is slower. They may have altered hepatic or renal function. So be aware of that because that may affect the dosage that's given for them. Also be aware of polypharmacy. Our geriatric patients, many of them are on 5 or 6 or more medications, and there may be some interactions with that, so be aware of those. Our pediatric patients, of course, they have lower body weight, so that's going to affect the dosage. The premature patient may have impaired metabolism, so those are some considerations with the pediatric patient. Next is the right time. Of course, make sure that the medication is given during the right time. Know your abbreviations. Most hospitals will have a standard time. If it's ordered in the morning, it may be 9 a.m. or 10 a.m., those kind of things. And time may be in military time too, so know your military time. PRN medications, make sure you look and you know the last time that those were given. If they're ordered every 4 hours, PRN or as needed, when was the last time that PRN medication was given? The right route, make sure that you administer that medication in the right route, by whether it's by mouth or intramuscular, subcutaneous, intravenous, per rectum, or intradermal. Right documentation is important. Do not record the medication until after you give it. That's another safety factor and an important safety factor. Of course, if the medication is refused, make sure that you document that and why or why not. Right diagnosis. This is a new one with this textbook, and I think it's an important one. So does the diagnosis match the purpose of the drug? For example, if you would have a patient in for a cardiac problem and they're ordered antibiotics. So does that antibiotic seem appropriate? If not, you need to go back and double check that. You need to check laboratory work with many medications. Is it at the therapeutic level? Many drugs will do therapeutic levels. Many drugs, you have to make sure that they have kidney function to give it. For example, metformin. So you might want to look at that BUN and creatinine and make sure that they have kidney function. You also may want to check vital signs before a lot of medications. If it's a medication that alters blood pressure or pulse, you'll want to check that before you give it. Or medications that depress the nervous system, like our heavy-duty pain medications, they may suppress vital signs and respirations. So you'll want to check vital signs before you give that medication. The right response is a consideration. Of course, if you give a blood pressure medicine, has it brought that blood pressure down? Next is the right to refuse. Of course, our patients have the right to refuse medications. If they do, though, please make sure that the patient understands what that medication is for, that there's correct comprehension of that, and also what the ramifications may be if they do not take that medication. And then make sure that you document that the patient refused and that you discuss those things with the patient. Lastly, here's some more general principles of administration of medications. Know your med. If you're going to give a medication, you must know it. You must know what the use is, the action, what common side effects are, adverse reactions, and precautions. In your textbook, they kind of use side effects and adverse reactions kind of interchangeably, although in my book, they're very different. Common side effects are things that we can work with, like constipation or nausea. They're things that are common to the drug. Adverse reactions are life-threatening reactions. So you may need to know what those are with some of those medications. Other considerations would be the patient's history. Do they have any allergies? Have they had any previous reaction to that medication or problem with it? Have there been any important changes in their health recently? And lastly, are there any limitations on administration by the physician? Has the physician written to hold the blood pressure medicine if the diastolic is below 100, or hold the medication if the pulse is below 60. So make sure you look to see that the physician or the facility has not placed limitations on that medication. Well, that's it for some safety principles for safe medication administration. If you have any questions, please bring them to class.